two Crosstown rivals meet tonight for the annual Holy War at Riverfront Stadium, as the 4-1 Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders face off against the 2-3 Bishop Carroll Golden Eagles. I'm Andrew Guyer, and I'm joined by my co-host,
Robbie Richardson.
It has been 26 years since the Crusaders have bested the Eagles, and the last victory was in 1996. And if the Crusaders want to beat them tonight, they will need to establish the run game early. This KMC senior heavy offense is led by running back and Air Force commit Amari Elias. Elias has rushed for just under 1,200 yards on the season and will be a key factor in a win tonight. At quarterback, KMC is led by senior Dylan Hamilton and is backed by a strong offensive line. They have been creating rush lanes all season long. On the defensive side of the ball, KMC is backed by junior linebackers Jackson Daniel and Kyle Kea, as well as brothers Will and Nathan Thingvall. This KMC defense has switched up this year, and their golden night is to limit those big plays and stop the run.
Tonight, the Carroll offense is being led by their senior quarterback, Jackson King, and their senior running back, Thomas Georges. Their line is being led tonight by senior and UNLV commit Hank Georges. And Carroll's record today coming in is 2-3, with their only losses coming to Derby, Northwest, and Junction City. Comparing that to Capen's 4-1 record, with their only loss coming to Northwest. Both teams are coming in today with their own unique playing styles of this game. Capen's playing style is a run-heavy offense with Henry Chrisman and Amari Elias, while Carroll will be spreading the ball out tonight and throwing the ball a lot.
So, the broadcast starts in just under 10 minutes, so grab your popcorn, grab a drink, and be ready to watch the Holy War. Hello and welcome to the 2023 Holy War between the 4-1 Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders and the 2-3 Bishop Carroll Golden Eagles. I'm Andrew Guyer, and I'm joined by my co-host,
Robbie Richardson.
And tonight's matchup is between the run-heavy offense of the Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders versus the very spread offense of Carroll. KMC is led on the offensive side by seniors Amari Elias and Dylan Hamilton. And if KMC wants to win this game, they'll need to establish the run game early through Amari Elias, as he has just under 1,200 yards on the season. On the other side of the ball, KMC is led by senior Jackson Daniel and junior Jackson Daniel and Kyle Kea, along with seniors Will and Nathan Thingvall. And Robbie, how is this Bishop Carroll offense?
You know, throughout these past couple of weeks, the Carroll offense has it's been productive, but they've been missing that extra little hump they need to get over. They need to establish this run game if they want to have a good game. Passing the ball around, it'll help them, but they need to establish the run game first, and then they can get more into that passing.
And Carroll is led by star offensive lineman and UNLV commit Hank Purvis, along with senior quarterback and senior running back Jackson King and Thomas Georges. And both teams will meet in the center for the coin toss. And the last KMC victory was in 1996, and that is over 26 years ago. And around that time, Robbie, I mean, you and I were not around. Many of the KMC students were not around, and some of the faculty had never seen a KMC victory. And in 1996, Michael Jordan still played for the Bulls, leading the NBA, and the Macarena was the number one song that year.
You're absolutely right, Andrew. If KMC comes out with a victory tonight, it'll be a spectacle of a show. And if they want to win, this will be the biggest moral victory they've had in a while.
Yeah, and both teams circle this date on their calendar, preparing all season long. As I talked to some of the football players earlier this week, they said how much a victory would mean to them, the students, and the KMC alumni and community. They've waited a long, long time for this. And this would be even bigger on this stage tonight at Riverfront Stadium. And both teams going to their sideline as KMC elects to receive first.
Like we were talking about earlier, Andrew, the parts of the offenses, what they need to do is Carroll needs to throw the ball effectively, but they also need to establish the run.
And tonight's kickoff is sponsored by Pella Windows and Doors.
Let's get this game underway, folks.
And Jackson Daniel is back to receive for the Crusaders. And that is fielded by Elias, as he is wrapped up by a group of Bishop Carroll defenders. And this KMC offense trots out onto the field. And like we said earlier, led by seniors Amari Elias and senior quarterback Dylan Hamilton. And KMC's victory tonight will be on the ground if they choose to do so. And Elias breaks one free right away out of the gate, past the 50, past the 40, as he is shoved out of bounds. Very solid run to kick off the game for Elias.
Wow, what a great start for this Cape and offense. Mari finding that gap and riding up the side of the line of the sideline just to get a great first down at a ton extra yardage.
And that is credited to that senior offensive line protecting Elias and Dylan Hamilton. And on first down, Elias is swallowed up by a group of Carroll defenders. And that brings up second down and 9 for the Crusaders. Hand off to Crispin as he gets barely anything on the play. And that brings up third and mid for the Crusaders.
Henry Crispin, over these past couple of weeks, have had some sneaky good games. See what he wants to do here tonight.
And first third down of the game, Dylan Hamilton passing it to Trip Wright as he dashes into the end zone. And the Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders get on the board first in the 2023 Holy War.
Wow, that is a great way to start this game for this KMC team. They really wanted to come out here swinging, and that's just what they did with a great Amari Elias run and a great read by Dylan Hamilton.
And that KMC touchdown is brought to you by Emprise Bank. Possible starts at Emprise. And Chase DuPont back from a small injury on for the extra point as it is good. KMC going up 7-0 against Bishop Carroll. And that is a statement drive for the Crusaders. And when I talked to them earlier this week, they said they want to keep their foot on the gas all night long, not taking it off one bit. And a little bit of trickery there, faking the handoff to Elias as Dylan Hamilton goes on the bootleg to connect with Trip Wright.
That was a great play design. It caught the Carroll defense off guard, and that was a walk-in touchdown for Trip Wright. Let's see how this kickoff goes.
And Chase DuPont on for the kickoff for the Crusaders as Thomas Georges and Van Hanberg back to receive for the Golden Eagles. And Hanberg fields the kick. And he is shoved out of bounds by Austin Howard. And the Bishop Carroll offense making its way onto the field. They are led by senior quarterback number 18, Jackson King, and running back Thomas Georges, as this offense looks to spread out the ball, pass it all around, confuses KMC defense. And on the other side, KMC looking to preserve their lead and keep this game out of reach for Carroll. And that's a handoff to Georges. He is stopped by a group of KMC defenders.
Over the past couple weeks, we've seen this KMC defense. They've done a great job on the defensive line, stopping the run and getting to the quarterback effectively.
And if Bishop Carroll wants to establish this run, they're going to look to their star offensive lineman, Hank Purvis, as Hank received an offer and committed to UNLV earlier this year. King taking it himself as he moves upfield. And he is tackled by junior Noah Schreck. And it looks that Carroll's going to use a little bit of that, mixing it up, giving it to Georges. King keeping it himself, or give it to one of their receivers, such as Hanberg.
They did a great job there of tricking the KMC defense to see what they do.
And that is a first down. And second down brings up not very much. And good stop by this KMC defense. keeping the ground game irrelevant. And excuse me, it doesn't even look like Hank Purvis is out there as he is sidelined. And a second down pass complete to King's receiver.
Carroll has done a great job at getting this passing game started. They've done a great job at getting those short little yardages.
And third down and short for the Golden Eagles. King keeping it himself. And Kea in for the tackle for KMC. And back to the offensive line. It looks like Pittman is in for Purvis at center tonight. We don't know exactly why Purvis is not out there, but Pittman is taking his spot. And another Carroll first down. Let's see what they do here. They've been trying to establish this run game, just like KMC keeping it on the ground. Let's see if they try to trick the Crusaders with something through the air. King staying in the pocket. Sees pressured. Dodges a tackle and is forced to throw that one out of bounds.
Like we've seen over that past couple of weeks, the edge rushers are getting to King effectively. They're making him pressured. They're making him feel that heat. He has to throw away the ball and nearly avoids an interception by Jackson Daniels.
And that shows a little bit of this, of Pittman coming in for Purvis. They don't have as much experience on that line with missing their senior star. And so that might be a little bit of a learning curve going into this game. And King giving it to Georges on second down. And that looks to be a small gain of around 2 yards.
If Capen stops them here, he forces them to punt. It would be a great victory for them.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Robbie. If KMC can stop this high-powered Carroll offense and force a punt, that would be big. And then go down the field to score and add to that lead. King dropping back to throw just over the head of his receiver, Hanberg, as he was guarded by Charlie Crispin.
If King did not overthrow that, that may have been a touchdown.
Yeah, Hanberg was wide open, a field of grass right in front of him. That brings up fourth down for the Golden Eagles. And the offense stays on the field, signaling to the sideline. King dancing out to his right. And he's running for it. And he's hit Jackson Daniel on the tackle.
Wow, that is a spectacular stop for KMC.
And that is a turnover that they needed right there as this KMC offense is coming back onto the field. Very, very strong drive. Right around 3 to 4 plays. Elias and Crispin in the backfield. And up to Elias. As he looks to get about 4 on the play.
Like you said earlier, Andrew, this KMC team says they wanted to keep their foot on the accelerator. Well, so far in this game, it looks like they're slamming down on the accelerator, really bringing what they wanted to these past 26 years.
Mm-hmm. All those losses piling up. just adds salt to the wound for tonight as Elias dances out to the sideline, getting, looks to be a gain of around 15. As that brings up a KMC first down.
That's what's so special about Amari Elias. If you bounce him to the outside, he will find those extra yards, and he will get you those first downs.
And that first down was brought to you by Schaefer Architecture. Proud to support Kansas High School Athletics. Thank you, Schaefer. And Elias, again, as he finds a way to get something on the play. And Robbie, it looked like Elias was beat by all those Carroll defenders, but he found a way through that offensive line. Some great blocking by those seniors.
Yes, that offensive line really gave him those extra yards and really helped him there.
And second down, Elias. Not much there. Looks to be a gain around one.
Looks like it'll be a third and one. That's what they're going to do here.
And a handoff to Crispin. Not much on the play.
Henry Crispin has been a reliable third and short guy, finding those gaps and just getting those easy extra yards for the first down.
And excuse me, it looks like KMC gained a first down on that play, keeping the drive alive. Elias in the backfield once again, handoff. And he is tackled by another group of Carroll defenders.
Carroll defenders read that play like a book, getting to Elias fast.
And this KMC offense looks to be running like a heavy set, multiple tight ends on that field with one or two receivers. As Dylan Hamilton on the quarterback keeper breaks free. Touchdown. Capen, Mount Carmel.
Wow, what a great play design by Sharks. Faking out to his best player on the offense, Amari Elias, for Dylan Hamilton to just walk it into the end zone. What a great play.
And great blocking by the offensive line as well, setting up that play, creating those running lanes. And that was not what that BC defense expected. As KMC looks to go up 14-0 with Chase DuPont on for the extra point. That touchdown was brought to you by Emprise Bank. And the extra point is good. KMC, 14. Bishop Carroll, 0. And this has to get the fans, the students, feeling very, very excited, very happy about how the game is looking thus far. With it being 26 years, anything like this is exciting.
This is exactly what the Capen team wanted to do. They wanted to start off to a good start. They wanted to keep the Carroll offense limited, and they wanted to get into the end zone quick. That is exactly what they've done so far in this first quarter.
And this kickoff is brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors. And Chase DuPont on for the kick. Thomas Georges and Van Hamburg on to receive for Bishop Carroll. And Hamburg fielding the kick as he's tackled right around the 20-yard line. Dylan Burr on the tackle.
If you're the Carroll offense right now, you want to get a big play to get this momentum going your way. You really want to establish that run game right now.
And with the Bishop Carroll offense staying on the field last drive, on that fourth down play. That has to be just demoralizing, not being able to convert and giving the ball right back to that high-powered KMC offense. And hand off to Georges. As he gets around 2 yards on the play.
If this Capen team keeps this up all night, it looks to be a great performance by Capen.
And second and 8 for the Golden Eagles. King keeping it himself, dancing around KMC defenders as he is tackled by Sam Bezdek.
That's kind of what's lacking in these past couple of weeks of this Capen offense. If they bounce to the outside, they'll get some extra yardage.
You're exactly right, Robbie. This KMC defense has been focusing a lot of their effort on the inside, trying to prevent those difficult pounding the balls. And King, his pass is complete as Hanberg comes up with the catch. And just a solid play design by the Golden Eagles, getting that first down when they needed it most. And that first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture, proud to support Kansas High School Athletics. And King on the keeper once again as Daniels comes up with the tackle.
That's what makes this kid so special. He's so great at finding who has the ball and what he needs to do. He read the play, knew that King had the ball, tracked him down, and got him for an easy loss of yardage.
And that brings up second down and long for Bishop Carroll. And King in the pocket. His pass complete to his receiver. To Cal Purvis. And a diving catch exactly what this Bishop Carroll offense needed to light the spark and start a drive. And that brings them around the 50-yard line with another first down. King keeping it himself. So he moves upfield, dodging some defenders as Daniels on for another tackle.
It was a great read by King. Found that open hole and knew that he could get that first down.
And that's just that experienced Bishop Carroll offensive line moving those lanes and creating those opportunities for their quarterback.
So far tonight, Carroll has done a great job at running the ball on the outside. Let's see if they want to continue to do that.
And first down for the Eagles. King stepping back as his pass is incomplete.
King received a lot of pressure on that play. That may have affected the throw of the ball there.
And with just over a minute left in the first quarter of play, KMC very happy, jumping out to a 14-point lead as this Holy War streak is at play tonight. 26 years, and KMC is not trying to make it 27. as King bounces to the outside, getting a first down, and he is tackled by Charlie Crispin. That brings up another Carroll first down.
King tonight is letting the Capen defense know that he is here, and he is trying to run all over them. He's done a great job so far tonight.
It's a little bit of mystery. They don't know who it's going to go to, King, Georges. A little bit of that option play. And King can definitely move it with his legs. We've seen that many, many times. And King dropping back. Pass over the head of Hanberg. As that brings up second down.
That's a big play. That could have resulted in a touchdown if that was underthrown just a little bit more.
And Carroll trying to go for the big play here, trying to get on the board. And good defense by Noah Schreck, KMC DB. And second down, three receivers for Bishop Carroll. That is caught. And that looks to be a loss of yardage on the play. Flax with the reception for Carroll.
Carroll trying to catch that Capen defense off guard with that little screen play. Noah Schreck read it, though, and got the tackle.
Third and 15, never a spot you want to be in when you're approaching the red zone. Let's see what this Carroll offense, Dusty Trail, has drawn up. And signaling to the sideline. And it looks to be a timeout on the play. Excuse me. End of the first quarter as the Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders lead 14-0 over the Bishop Carroll Golden Eagles.
Andrew, if I'm the Cape and Crusaders right now, I would be very happy with the start to the game.
You are exactly right, Robbie. Jumping out to an early lead is always something you want to do. And at the beginning of the game, we talked about how KMC needed to establish their run game if they wanted to win. And that is exactly what they're doing, keeping it on the ground. Dylan Hamilton scoring, and Amar Elias getting those big chunk yardage plays to set up the passing touchdown to trip right. A little bit of trickery by KMC. And we'll see moving forward what they do, if they continue to that, or if they throw it more. And tonight's game is brought to you by Grasshopper Mowers and Ernatt Art and Bronze. Thank you both for sponsoring us at KMC Journalism.
Is the defense. They did a great job at stopping them on the Carroll's first possession, stopping them from getting that touchdown, stopping them on that important fourth down. What do you think?
And bringing up all the stats, KMC 5 first downs on the game with Carroll's 6. And this Carroll offense, they've been moving the ball. They've been finding a way. I know it doesn't say anything on the scoreboard, but they've been able to move the ball, except for that fourth down that they could not convert. King dropping back once again. A pass to his receiver. Incomplete to Hanberg. Crispin on the play. Right through his hands. Wow. That's never never something you want to see. King giving his receiver a good ball. It just wasn't there.
That may have turned the tide for this game. That would have been a huge play for the for this Carroll offense. Right through the hands.
And that brings up third and 15 for the Golden Eagles. Georges in the backfield. King stepping back once again. Pass complete, but he is tackled right away. And Will Thingvall on the tackle for KMC. And there is a Bishop Carroll player down on the field. And that looks to be Hamburg.
Never something you want to see out of your star receiver. Looks like he got up on his own power, though. It's a good sign.
And he's moving on the sideline. That's a good sign that he might return for this offense. And Cape Carmel bringing the offense back onto the field. They've had a lot of success. Past two drives have resulted in touchdowns. And keeping on the ground with Elias as he finds some space for a 5-yard gain.
This offensive line is really giving Amari big holes to get through. He's done a great job in reading that.
And this offensive line has played together for many years since they were in middle school. All this group of guys has learned and grown up together, just creating that team chemistry. And Elias, not much on the play. And that brings up third down.
Looks like the ball may have popped out. Carroll thought it was their ball, but it looks like Caitlin was down the field.
And this KMC offense is staying on as Hamilton's pass is incomplete to Thingvall. And a big heave by Hamilton, just hoping to connect with his star receiver. And it's no good.
That was one of the first big blunders that we've seen tonight for this Cape offense. Obviously, that's not what you want to see, but it's better than an interception or a fumble.
And that drive resulted in a 3-and-out as Cash Undrels is back to receive for the Golden Eagles.
Capen has elected to take their first timeout of the half.
And for KMC, that's not necessarily a disappointing drive. It's just, it slows the momentum a little bit. Coming out, beginning the game scoring 14 points. Big momentum booster. So that's just a little hiccup in the road. And a little.
Absolutely, Andrew. You know, that's not what you want to see, but it's better than turning the ball over to Carroll. It looks like they are going to go ahead and punt it.
And coming out of timeout, KMC on to punt Jackson Daniel. And the punt is botched by Undrels. And it looks to be Bishop Carroll's ball as they recover the ball. And this KMC defense charging back out onto the field. They've been very successful holding Bishop Carroll in this spread offense to only to no points. And last drive was promising for the Golden Eagles, but nothing came of it. And King keeping it himself as he is pushed out of bounds. Looks to be just short of a first down.
We've seen that play multiple times tonight, and we've seen it work every single time. Let's see how Capen wants to adjust to that.
Yeah, and Carroll has just been able to bounce it out to the outside, and they've been able to find some success there with that offensive line shifting and moving blockers. And second down, Georges. And that looks to be a first down for the Golden Eagles. And that first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture, proud support of Kansas High School Athletics.
They've tried to establish this run game, and we'll see how they want to continue to do that throughout the game.
King in and off. Excuse me. King on the faker. Incomplete to his receiver. That looks like Hamburg on the attempt. And that pass was broken up by Thingvall. Great job of getting in there, reading the ball, and not letting that be completed.
Thingvall using his long wingspan to his advantage, knocking that ball free.
And that brings up second and 10 for the Golden Eagles. As whistles are called, and penalty on the Golden Eagles, as that will set them back around 5 yards, bringing up second and 15.
Never something you want to see, but part of the game.
And once again, second down. Georges in the backfield. King, once again, keeping it himself, dodging defenders as he is finally taken down. And that looks to be Charlie Crispin on the tackle.
What King is so great at. He's able to find those open holes on the outside, bounce to them, and get that easy extra yardage.
And that brings up third and 7 for Bishop Carroll. King dropping back, pass complete to his receiver Hamburg. And we'll see if that was enough for a first down.
It was a spectacular catch by Hamburg. Just a little bit short of that first down marker.
And King finding his checkdowns there. Nice, easy reads. And great job by Hamburg getting open. And Georges on the run. Looks to be enough for a first down. Solid blocking. That was a very close call. Matter of inches there.
Carroll so far has done a great job at running on third and short. Let's see how they want to incorporate the run game more with their running backs.
And King giving it to Georges once again as a flag flies near the line of scrimmage. As Georgia's got a short gain. And a face mask is called on KMC, as that will move the chains for the Golden Eagles, setting them past the 35-yard line. And another first down, getting inside KMC territory. Bishop Carroll just within striking distance of the end zone. And King, a keeper once again. A little bit of room there to run. Looks to be a short gain of around 5.
King is really showing tonight why he is a dual threat quarterback. He's done a great job on the ground, and he's done a great job throwing the ball too.
You're exactly right, Robbie. He can do it both with his arm and his legs. And that is what KMC needs to cover. And if he finds too much room, he can be a problem tonight. And second down. Keeper once again to bring up another first down.
Gapin wants to stop this Carroll offense. They're going to need to stay on King, and they're going to want to keep him from getting those easy yards.
And that Bishop Carroll first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture. And with just over 6 minutes left in the second quarter of play, Bishop Carroll looks to get on the board, down by 14. To Cape Mount Carmel. And a handoff to Georges as he gets around 5 on the play. And Carroll over 100 yards of scrimmage on that play. King keeping it himself once again as he's tackled by Crispin. And it seems to be working for the Golden Eagles, giving it to King, and he's making his way all around the field, finding those lanes and getting any type of gain for the Golden Eagles. And King taking it once again, as he is very close to the end zone, just shy.
King is leaving his Cape and defense confused and dwindled. They don't know what to do with him.
Second and 3, another keeper to King. And not quite a touchdown there. Bringing up third down for the Golden Eagles. 3 yards to go until the end zone. Let's see what they bring out here, what type of sets. This could be a fullback type of situation or a check down to the receiver, Hanberg.
If I'm Carroll, I trust my quarterback enough to make the right read. If he wants to use his legs, use his legs. If he wants to use his arm, use his arm.
And King keeps it once again, and he is stopped just short of the end zone.
This is not good. King looks to be a little shaken up here.
And Noah Schreck on the tackle. King moving around looks to be in pain a bit. Looks to be his ankle area. Not a great spot to be injured for a quarterback.
Carroll might want to take a timeout here, just reflect and kind of design a play where they can get into the end zone, with, maybe without King, keep him preserved.
And all three attempts came up short. Fourth down, KMC holding strong on defense, not letting anything through easily. And a timeout is called by the Golden Eagles.
If King is taken out of this game, that'd be terrible for the Carroll Eagles. They've done everything with King so far. They've ran with him. He's done a great job at throwing the ball. Let's see what they're going to do here. Try to put a quarterback spy on him. He's been running the ball outside of the lanes. He's been running inside. They've done a great job with that. If I'm caping, try to put something on him. He's getting the ball every single down. And he's been capitalizing on it.
And I wouldn't be surprised here, Robbie, if Bishop Carroll created some type of either a play action, run a boot, like go out to the left or the right and pass it to Hamburg, Flax, or Purvis, either one of those guys, because they've been keeping on the ground a lot, and that KMC defense might be a little accustomed to that. But it is fourth and one, so you never know. And the push, quarterback sneak, as King makes his way into the end zone for Bishop Carroll touchdown. Brought to you by Imprise Bank.
Well, it looks like King fooled us there. He looked fine on that, and he looked fine getting out. He's a great athlete, and let's hope he's okay.
And Bishop Carroll on for the extra point. Murphy. And the kick is good. And you figured if you were KMC, that is the exact play they would run. Quarterback sneak. Very, very good play. Very difficult to block and defend. And Carroll finding their way on to the board. As this game is 14-7. With 3 minutes left in the second quarter of play.
I don't blame the KMC defense. It's very hard to stop the quarterback sneak.
And they've given up 121 yards on the ground to both Georges and to King, majority of that coming through King on the quarterback keepers. And Murphy on the kick for Bishop Carroll as it soars out of bounds.
That will set up the Capen offense on the 40-yard line. That's what you want to see for Capen. It's a great spot where you want to be.
And last possession, KMC. Not quite the type of drive that they wanted. Giving it back to Carroll on a three and out. So once again, KMC coming out. They still have a little bit of momentum, but that last Carroll drive took a little bit out of them. So let's see how they rebound. See if they keep it on the ground to Amari, or if they go to the air through Thingball or one of the tight ends. And hand off to Crispin. As he looks to get about four on the play. And KMC looking to speed this possession up a little bit. Time running down as Hamilton moves out to the outside. And he is tackled by a group of Carroll defenders.
If I'm Capen right now, I'd want to start incorporating the passing a little bit more. Obviously, they've got a great running back in Amari Elias, but with this third and long, they're going to want to try to pass it and establish that passing.
You are exactly right, Robbie. And with time approaching the end of the quarter, they're going to need to hurry this up and get some passing plays in to speed up that process. And Hamilton out to pass as he is pressured. Passes off and is incomplete. Peyton Gosh on the target as a swarm of Eagles in for the deflection.
Wow, that is not what you want to see from this Capen offense. Two four and outs. That is not what you want to see. Great breakup by Minton.
And Unjust on for the punt return. Daniels on to punt for the Crusaders. And that one bounces before it heads out of bounds. And Carroll, excellent field position going into the final minutes of the first half.
Capen right now, they're seeming a little shaken up, a little disoriented out there, and they just need to reflect, calm down, and just remember to go out there, and they need to go do their best right now.
Yeah, and KMC is just trying to figure out the rhythm, trying to stop King. He's had a lot of success on the ground, contributing to their 121 yards of total scrimmage. Much of that has been on the ground as King takes it once again as he finds a way to get out and he's free. Green grass right in front of him as he is in the end zone once again for another Bishop Carroll touchdown as they are within striking distance of KMC. 1 point divides the two. And Robbie, that was very uncharacteristic of KMC, not letting those big plays happen. They're normally right on top of it. But King found his way around the sideline, and he was able to dash into the end zone to score.
Absolutely right. That is not what you want to see from this KMC defense. All the momentum was on their side in the first quarter. It looks like Carroll took all that momentum right back. They have not guarded King as they wanted to, and they need to reflect during this halftime, and they need to find out a way to stop him and get this offense going again.
And with this game tied 14-14, Carroll scoring very, very quickly into that possession. The KMC thinking that they would maybe have a chance to score before halftime. It's just another nail in the coffin as KMC looks to get something on the board before the end of the second half. And Murphy on the kick for Bishop Carroll. Daniels back to return as Shrek fair catches that one. And once again, this KMC offense returns onto the field. Robbie, tell me a little bit about last drive.
Well, last drive, they were given great field position on the 40. They tried to run it with Amari. They tried to run it with Chrisman. They couldn't get that going, so they tried throwing it. They just couldn't get it. This Carroll defense is doing great.
And Elias finding his way around for a solid gain, bringing up second and manageable for the Crusaders. And Elias just under 70 yards on the ground. And Crispin getting the KMC first down. Hamilton dashing around. And he is tackled. A large group of Carroll defenders taking him down. Small gain on the play. And this clock is still running. Under 40 seconds left. See if KMC tries to get something off as the clock continues to run. Hamilton out to pass. And he moves upfield, dashing out of bounds to stop the clock.
On that last possession, I think if I'm the KMC offense right now, I think I'm going to try to throw the ball downfield, trying to get at least something going to get this offense a little bit of a morale boost, just so they can keep that going into the half.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Going in to half, they want something to put up on the board to have the lead over Carroll. As Hamilton goes deep to his receiver, Daniels. Daniels evading the tackler and into the end zone for a Capen Mount Carmel touchdown as KMC adds six and is up over the Golden Eagles. Wow, what a strike to Daniels there. Robbie, what was going on there?
Just as we said, you want to get some points going, you want to get the throwing game established. Exactly what they did on that play. Great throw and great catch for a good 6 points.
And DuPont on for the kick. Right through the uprights. As that brings KMC up 7 over the Golden Eagles. And with just over 10 seconds left in the second quarter, KMC feeling a boost of momentum, a shot in the arm almost. Going into this half, they have to be feeling good.
I completely agree, Andrew. It was a great play designed by Sharks, and he got them the touchdown. Now let's see how they bring that into the second half with their defense.
And DuPont on for the kickoff. As this kickoff is brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors. Thomas Georges and Van Hamburg on to receive for the Golden Eagles. Fielded by Hamburg. And he's finding some room. Evading KMC defenders as he is eventually pushed out of bounds.
Looks to be a flag on the play there, but it won't matter much. There's about 3 seconds left on the clock. Won't be able to do much with that.
And let's see the call. Block in the back on the Golden Eagles. As that brings them well into their own territory around the 10-yard line. And like you said, Robbie, it won't matter much. 3 seconds left in the second quarter as they will take a knee. And as the clock winds down to zero, KMC up 21-14. Very quick score by Jackson Daniel to make it like that. And KMC has to be feeling great going in the locker room. It's been 26 years, and they're looking to stop that streak and not make it 27.
Exactly right, Andrew. They've done what they needed to do. Obviously, those two touchdowns, they didn't want to do that. but that's going to happen sometimes against a great offense like this Carroll Eagles have. They've done a great job at running the ball, and they did a great job at the end throwing the ball. Now let's see how they bring that into the second half.
And the KMC Pommies will perform at halftime. I'm Andrew Greer.
And I'm Robbie Richardson.
And we will see you in the second half.
By Sophie Rickenberg. Here we go for the game.
1-2. Bro.
Hello and welcome once again out of halftime. I'm Andrew Greer.
And I'm Robbie Richardson.
And KMC leads the Bishop Carroll Golden Eagles 21-14. And coming out of the half, KMC looks to maintain the momentum they felt. Hello and welcome back to the 2023 Holy War. I'm Andrew Greer.
And I'm Robbie Richardson.
And we're joining you right out of halftime as the Cape and Mount Carmel Crusaders lead 21-14 over the Bishop Carroll Golden Eagles. And right before the half, KMC added one more touchdown to the board, making it 21-14 into the half, and that was a bit of momentum for the Crusaders. They had lost a little bit going on back-to-back three and out drives, not getting much out of that, and then they struck right before halftime.
Absolutely. They had those two disappointing four and outs, and then they came out with their last possession strong, throwing a deep ball to Jackson Daniels for 6 points.
And on for the kickoff, Chase DuPont kicking it to Thomas Georges and Van Hanberg for Bishop Carroll. And the kick is fielded by Hanberg as he avoids a tackle, making his way past the 40 as he is finally taken down by a KMC defender.
That is a great way for this Carroll team to start off with the second half. Great yardage for the Carroll team, and they're able to produce off of this.
And great job by Hanberg adjusting and avoiding that tackle and getting more out of that. He could have lost, like, he was around the 20, and he got another 20 yards, moving them up to the 45. As King and Georges are in the backfield for Bishop Carroll, and they have found a lot of success on the ground, giving it back to Georges as he is met very soon as he gets a gain of around 3 yards.
Georges tonight has been productive on the short ball game. He's not been getting a whole lot of explosive plays, but he's been getting those little extra yardages.
You're exactly right, Robbie, and they've been saving those chunk plays for Jackson King. And he's been finding his way to the outside and producing big yardage, big runs. And King on the keeper once again, tackled by Trip Wright. As that brings up third down for the Golden Eagles. Three receivers out wide. George is in the backfield once again. And handing off to Georges as he breaks free, finding room, putting on the gas as he tumbles into the end zone for a Bishop Carroll touchdown.
That is a great way to come out of the half for that Carroll offense. Like we said earlier, not a ton of explosive plays from Hamburg, but he finally got one there, getting it about a 50-yard touchdown for Carroll.
And that touchdown is brought to you by Emprise Bank. Possible starts at Emprise. And Murphy on for the extra point for the Golden Eagles. And that sailed wide left. As that brings the score to 21-20 in favor of the Crusaders. And Georges, as soon as he saw that grass in front of him, he put on the gas, bolting for that end zone. And he left those KMC defenders in the dust. They did not know what hit them.
What the main reason for confusion may be on that play is that Capen, they were prioritizing King on that. You know, Carroll hasn't been using Hindenburg as much, and he was able to get the 50-yard touchdown off of him.
And Murphy on for the kick. And this kickoff is brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Kansas. Daniels on for the return. As it is fielded by Noah Schreck. And he gets to around the 35. And this KMC offense trotting back out onto the field, looking to respond to that very early Bishop Carroll touchdown. And Robbie, tell me a little bit about last quarter and how they struck right before halftime.
Well, the Capen offense was out on the field and they tried running the ball, didn't get much success on it. It was about a 3rd and 5. You know, they were really wanting to try to score on that, and they were looking for the first down, but Dylan Hamilton was able to find Jackson Daniels deep, connect with him, and good for about a 60-yard touchdown.
And KMC is looking to recreate that play right here. See what they can do. Elias bouncing out to the outside and moving upfield, getting a first down for the Crusaders. As that first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture. Proud to support Kansas High School Athletics. And handoff to Crispin as he finds a seam, getting around 7 yards on the play. And Crispin, you thought he was down? He found a way to get through those defenders, push through, and evade the tackles. And Elias getting the first down. And that brings them around the 25-30-yard line. Knocking at the door of another touchdown. Hand off to Elias. Not much on that play. And he's pushed back.
This is where this Carroll defense has done great tonight. They've done great within their own part of the field, and they've done great at stopping the run here, and they've done great at stopping the passing.
And Hamilton, shovel pass to Elias. and dancing on the sideline, finding some yardage as he gets around 5 on the play, bringing it to around the 35. Excuse me, 25.
Great call by Daniels there to shovel it off to Elias to get that easy yardage close to a first down.
And Elias up over 90 yards as he is stopped at that line. Carroll doing a great job of managing the trenches and not letting Elias fit through those seams.
If I was caping right now, I'd try to let Amari kind of go to the outside. That's where he's experienced, and that's where he's done great.
And Hamilton finding space, and he is into the end zone for a Capen Mount Carmel touchdown as they add 6 to their lead, making it 27-20 as that touchdown is brought to you by Emprise Bank. Possible starts at Emprise.
It looked to be a little bit of confusion while the play was going on, but Hamilton, experienced enough to know what to do in that situation, he was able to find that hole and get in for 6.
And he saw that open field and put on the gas, not letting up as the Bishop Carroll defender just missed him. And DuPont's kick is right through the uprights as that extends the KMC lead by 8, as that makes this 28-20.
That is now 2 rushing touchdowns for Dylan Hamilton tonight. You know, he's an underrated dual threat quarterback, and he's done great so far in this couple weeks that we've seen him.
You're exactly right, Robbie. And something KMC hasn't done as much this season is give it to Hamilton. Hamilton hasn't kept it much himself, and he's given it to Crispin or Elias. And so that's a little bit of the trickery tonight, catching Carroll off guard. And DuPont on for the kick for KMC. Hanberg and Georges on to receive for Bishop Carroll. And DuPont skies that kick to Georges. Georges getting tackled around the 20-25 yard line.
If I was the Carroll offense right now, I know King has done great so far in this game, but like we saw in that last drive, Georges so far, you know, he's been kind of quiet with production until that very last play. He's done great. I think as a Carroll offense, I'd want to trust him a little bit more on this drive.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they went back to their senior running back and fed him the ball a little bit more. And this KMC defense, one of the changes that they made this year was trying to limit big plays, and that is something that they haven't been as well at in this game. They're just trying to go back to that basic defense. And King evading the pressure of Kyle Kea and getting to the 30-yard line.
Well, we've seen that movie multiple times. King is a great athlete, and he evaded the tackle on that first initial touch.
And that brings up 2nd and 5 for the Golden Eagles. And one receiver out wide as they have a heavy set inside. Georges tackled by Hudson Cahill as he gets the first down. And that first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture.
As Carroll, I'm happy to see that. I'm happy to see that George is getting more involved in the game.
King back in the pocket as he is sacked
Nathan Thingvall coming in and putting the pressure on King. A large loss on the play.
That is exactly what we've been seeing from that Capen defensive line through the past couple of weeks. They were quiet the first half, and it looks like they may be coming back.
They've been putting the pressure on that quarterback. When he steps back, he better be ready for a KMC pass rush. And Georges and King in the backfield. Hand off to Georges as he is stopped at the line. And that brings up third and long for the Golden Eagles. And tonight, Carroll has had a lot of success on the ground. They just keep giving it to Georges or having King have a quarterback keeper. We haven't seen too much in the air from them. King stepping back. And he is sacked once again. Micah Amphong on the tackle. And great job by this KMC pass rush. It was a third and long, and they knew exactly what they needed to do as they sacked the quarterback. Bringing up fourth down.
That was a huge sack for this KMC defense. Twice in one possession. Great job by that defense.
And Carroll goes three and out as Hanberg punts. Two receivers back, and KMC elects to let it bounce. And they will get the ball around the 30-yard line. Trying to recreate last drive, keeping it on the ground a lot to Amari, and then Dylan Hamilton breaking free with a large gain.
Something a little bit more on this drive I'd like to see from KMC. It's kind of more of that trickery that we saw in that last drive. Try to fake it to Amari and just keep it for Dylan Hamilton.
And handoff to Amari Elias. And Elias bouncing outside, moving upfield. And he is finally taken down by a Carroll defender as he gets past midfield. However, there is a Carroll defender on the ground.
That's what makes Amari Elias so special, is that if you give him a little bit of space and he gets to the outside, he will make you pay for that, and he will get a lot of yards off of that.
And that looks to be Carter Morris, linebacker for the Golden Eagles. And both teams talking things over. KMC, if you're Coach Schartz or defensive coordinator, you must be very happy with that last possession. That resulted in exactly what you needed, giving the ball back to your offense and letting them work up by eight. Robbie, what do you want to see from this possession?
From this possession, I want to see the KMC offense establish and try to throw the ball just a little bit more than they have tonight. Obviously, they threw that big Jackson Daniel touchdown. I just want to see just a little bit more. And they've done a great job rushing tonight, too. 208 yards between Chrisman, Elias, and Hamilton. And they've had 87 yards passing as well.
And on the other side, Carroll. Well over 220 on the night in rushing. And Dylan Hamilton is taken down by Carroll defenders.
It was a great stop by Carroll. Just what they needed. And like I said earlier, they knew that they were going to try to trick him this half. And that's exactly what happened there.
And Elias in the backfield. Give to Elias. And he stumbles for, looks to be a gain of about four. Bringing up third down.
Capen tonight has done great on these third and longs. Trying to trick the defense, thinking they're going to Elias. going to the short option passes or going through Dylan Hamilton's scrambling abilities.
Two receivers out wide for KMC. And it was a handoff to Crispin, and he was stopped. Not quite the type of play that would normally result in a first down. KMC just trying to trick them, but it appears not to have worked.
Same here, Andrew. I'm a little confused on the call. Not exactly what you a play you would call on on third and long, but we'll see what Sharks wants to do here.
And the offense staying on the field. Elias in the backfield. Two receivers set. Crispin motioning out. And handoff to Daniels. And is that a first down? And it is. Moving the sticks, Jackson Daniels on the reverse. Great play by Coach Schartz, keeping the Carroll defense on their toes. And that first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture. And that is a handoff to Amari Elias.
You know, they've given a lot, Amari Elias, a lot of these inside runs. He's done great on them. But I want to see just a little bit more on the outside for Elias. He's done great out there, but he can also do great in the inside run.
You're exactly right, and he's helped KMC march down the field as they give it to him once again, bringing up third down and manageable. And with just under 2 minutes left, KMC looking to strike and add something to the board once again, up by eight. It's a manageable lead, but if you're KMC, you want to add more to that, and you want to keep it out of reach of that Bishop Carroll offense. And handoff to Elias as he is well over 130 on the night.
Capen is doing great at running the ball. This is not just for them to get yardage, but it's also tiring the defense, and the defense is getting tired of trying to just run inside and trying to get Amari down.
And Crispin into the end zone. A little bit of confusion there on the defensive line of Bishop Carroll. And great play draw. I was even confused. I thought it was going to Hamilton. And Crispin into the end zone.
We've seen that movie a couple of times throughout these weeks. You know, they're trying to fake it to Amari, or they think Hamilton's going to take it. They hand it off to Crispin, big hole in the middle for him to take it in.
And that brings him over 40 yards on the night. DuPont on for the kick, as it is good, bringing KMC up 15, making it 35-20, KMC.
If I'm Carroll right now, my morale is a little bit low. What I want here, I want a good run from King, a good pass, and I want to see George's a little bit more on those next drive.
And at the moment, KMC has the momentum. They're doing exactly what they need to do, jumping out to that lead. And they're producing on the offensive side of the ball, driving down the field a couple times. That possession looked like it would end, but Coach Schartz drew up a play that would keep it going, and they eventually found the end zone through Henry Crispin.
An underrated part of this game, too, I think, is this Capen defense, especially on that last drive, getting two sacks and forcing a four and out. Obviously, allowing the three touchdowns. It's not great, but it's better than not allowing them to score every single drive.
And DuPont on for the kickoff. Georges and Hanberg on to receive. Georges fielding it. And he is tackled by Hudson Cahill, the senior.
Okay, on this drive, all we need to see is Georges up the middle, and I think we also want to see some King running. We've seen that all night, but I want to see just a little bit more of Georges.
the Bishop Carroll offense trotting back out onto the field. And they've given it to Georges, and earlier in the third quarter, he broke free for a long run. They haven't seen much of that big run ability after that touchdown. And King on the quarterback keeper getting a first down and a little bit more.
Exactly what they brought into that first half, what they brought into that second half. They used King's legs, and the offensive line allowed him to get to the outside where he could get those extra yards.
And Bishop Carroll keeping KMC on their toes once again with King and Georges as two different options. And the give to Georges as he's using his speed once again to break away as that looks to be a big play. Let's look at the review there. Georges on a nice run, but he was stripped at the end. Noah Schreck, big play by the Crusaders. And that is a momentum shifter right there, adding more to the KMC momentum. Carroll thought, wow, that was a great run by Georges, but not enough. And Schreck was right there catching him off guard for the strip. And the give to Amari Elias as he gets around 2-3 on the play.
Back to that Georges run. That was exactly what you wanted to see out of your running back. A great hole up the middle, and he was able to get those yards. But he slowed down a little bit there and was not expecting Noah Schreck, and he got the strip.
And the third quarter comes to a close. And we would like to mention our sponsors for tonight, Ernatt Arts and Bronze and Grasshopper Mowers. Thank you for sponsoring the game. And one thing we haven't mentioned as much tonight, Robbie, is this student section. Both teams, they showed up. And when I talked to Coach Schartz earlier in the season, he said the student section is almost like a 12th man out there, adding to the environment, getting the players hyped and ready to play. And it just shows, it attests to these KMC students being able to come support the players.
I completely agree. Both teams' fan bases have come out and they've showed out tonight. They've not only mentally helped their teams, but they've also given them a boost of morale. And they've done a great job of doing that tonight.
Going into the final quarter of play. 12 minutes separates KMC from breaking the streak. As Amari Elias breaks free. 20, 10, touchdown. As he walks into the end zone. KMC touchdown. Just what they needed. Catching Bishop Carroll off guard. And that touchdown is brought to you by Emprise Bank. And as you can see there, the students excited about that, talking about the end. And Amari Elias just adding to that lead, putting Capen up 21 points.
Wow, that is what makes Amari Elias so spectacular. He can catch your defense off guard. He can bulldoze your defense.
And DuPont's kick is good. And on that last run, Amari Elias well over 220 yards alone by himself. Quite literally putting the team on his back and doing exactly what he needs to do.
You're absolutely right. Elias has been electric all game, nonstop, and he's done great so far with about 211 yards and one touchdown. Elias is also averaging a little bit more than 8 yards per carry, which is stupendous. You don't see that out of any normal running back.
And next year, Amari Elias is going to play for the Air Force Academy. And that's just something that just a culmination of his skill, and just he's an amazing talent for KMC, and he's had an amazing season. And so there's just a culmination of that in this game right here. And Chase DuPont on to kick for the Crusaders. Georges and Hanberg to return, as Hanberg receives it. And he is taken down around the 20-yard line.
Obviously, Hanberg has been a big factor in this game. He's done so much, not just on the kick returns, but he's also done great on the offense.
Yeah, he's been able to block for those runs, and he's even caught a few solid passes from his quarterback. Now, coming out, this offense, a little bit demoralized, only 20 points, and they haven't scored since early in the third quarter. Let's see how they respond to that KMC touchdown. And Georges looks to be a gain around 3.
This Capen defense in the second half has really prioritized King. And they've done it effectively, and they've done it well. They've only limited him to a couple of yards this quarter.
And a KMC defender is down on the field. That looks to be Hank Worth.
Andrew, this game, Capen, they've done amazing both sides of the ball. They've done great running. They've done amazing. I haven't seen a single thing that they've done wrong.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Robbie. Except for earlier in the first half, KMC was struggling a little bit. But it looks like out of halftime, they've rebounded, and they've established that run game, established that passing game. And they've found how to trick Carroll and keep them on their toes, not letting them gain an inch on defense. And then on offense, they are going all out. Like we said earlier, all gas, no brakes, not taking the foot off the pedal.
And it looks like Hinkworth was able to get up okay. It looks like it may have been a shoulder injury, but he was up and on his own power.
And second and manageable for the Golden Eagles. As Georges finding a small seam, getting a few yards on that play.
That's what I like to see, trusting your running back a little bit more, trusting Georges. I know that he had that unfortunate strip ball from him, but I like to see him be incorporated even after that.
Yeah, they still trust their senior running back to get the job done. But this KMC defense is not letting it come easy, as the ball is given once again to Georges, as he can't find much on the play.
Like we said earlier, this second half, they thought of prioritizing King's runs, and looks like they have done effectively throughout the second half.
And fourth and 2 for the Golden Eagles, as the offense stays on the field. And Georges, a whole lot of nothing on that play, as the KMC offense returns to the field once again. Robbie, tell me what KMC might be looking to do on this play.
On this drive, I would try to do what they do best. Run the ball with Elias, try to get that clock down, and try to run this game out. You do not want any chance of a comeback.
You're exactly right. Keep adding on to the lead. And the ball is given to Henry Chrisman, as not much on the play. and handoff to Elias as he's finding something once again, getting a KMC first down, as that first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture.
Elias is doing great so far throughout this game, finding those open holes.
And KMC is in the hurry up, trying to just keep the ball moving and add to their lead. Small gain on the play. And let's see if KMC stays on the ground or if they elect for Hamilton to drop back and try to throw something. And the pitch to Elias doesn't go too well as he is stopped for negative yardage.
That's okay on these types of drives. Obviously, it's not positive yardage, but you want to see them just run the clock down, not allow Carroll to have the ball.
And Hamilton out, moved around the pocket as he is taken down. Not much there. As that brings up fourth down for the Crusaders.
Hamilton was looking to his left for his receiver. Couldn't find him, and he was pressured, so he took the sack.
And Chase DuPont on for the field goal. And that's around the 30, so around a 40-yarder. And that is no good, as that drive unfortunately results in no points for the Crusaders. However, they still lead by 22 over the Golden Eagles.
If I was the Golden Eagles right now for their offense, I'd want to try to throw the ball just a little bit more, try to get downfield, try to get some points quick.
And this KMC defense comes back out very successful on last possession. And King scrambling out, pump faking it, and he's moving down the sideline. Gets out of bounds and around the 40.
King a little bit pressured, so he tried to scramble out of the pocket, and that's what he's done best tonight, scramble out of the pocket, got that easy first down, and was able to get some extra yardage after that.
And that first down is brought to you by Schaefer Architecture. King dropbacks to throw once again, caught by Hamburg. And he is still in bounds. Excuse me. He looks to have stepped out around the 45.
That's what I like to see. I know it's a little late in the game, but I'm happy to see that they're trusting the receivers more.
And let's see if Carroll continues to go through the air here. King dropping back, lofting one to his receiver as it drops incomplete. Pass intended for Hamburg.
We haven't really seen one of those tonight, one of those deep balls from King to Hamburg. Maybe we see one later in the fourth quarter, but we haven't seen one tonight.
Yeah, and it looks that Carroll's just trying to get anything going. They're trying to reestablish the momentum, and those deep balls seem to be the way that they're trying to do it. And the screen is no good. Pass intended for Flax.
This Capen defense has done great at defending those short little screen passes tonight, not allowing a whole lot of yardage out of those.
And that brings up 3rd and 10 for the Golden Eagles. And King's pass is incomplete. Pass intended for Hamburg.
It was a great pressure by that Capen defensive line. Able to hurry King up enough for him to just throw the ball away.
And that brings up 4th and 10 for the Golden Eagles. And Carroll taking a second to figure out what they're doing on this play.
And there's a flag on the play.
Delay of game, it looks to be. And Carroll just running out the clock. Bringing up 4th and 15. And they keep the offense on the field with just over 7 minutes left. Pass off the hands of Georges as the KMC offense returns to the field in high spirits, up 22. Not much better of a situation to be in at this point. Robbie, tell me what they can do on this possession.
I think for Capen, all you would need to do, run it with Elias, run it with Chrisman, and you're all good to go for a victory over Carroll. For the Carroll defense, there's not much you can do right now. The game is almost over, about 7 minutes left, and you're down 22. There's not much that can happen.
Yeah, and KMC is definitely going to run out that clock, keep it on the ground, and that would make it near impossible for Bishop Carroll to come back. And Crispin around midfield.
This Capen offense really would be really happy because they can bring this momentum into the next game for next week. They've done a great job today running the ball, and they did a pretty good job at throwing the ball as well.
And KMC just letting the clock run out as they approach 6 minutes left. Hand off to Elias as he looks to have gained around 3 on the play.
I think more than any game this year, this will be the biggest morale boost for Capen. Almost 26 years since they've won their last game against Carroll.
Yeah, and they're showing exactly the team that they are. When I talked to Coach Schartz earlier in the season, he said that they do not want to be known as the 5-5 Crusaders that they were last year. And they have done exactly that. They are showing the G-Wall and the state exactly who they are. They are high-powered offense with a very strong defense. And I think that this game reiterates that even more.
You're exactly right, Andrew. I totally agree with you. I think that the offense overshadows the defense a little bit. This is a great defensive unit, but Amari Elias is just so great that it kind of overshadows the defense as well. Elias also with 230 yards on the night with one touchdown with 27 attempts.
And Crispin finding a hole into the end zone. Crusader touchdown as he finds the end zone once again, adding to this lead as the Crusaders look to go up 29 over Bishop Carroll.
Wow, what a great way to pour salt in the wound there. Crispin finding the open hole, running for about a 30-yard touchdown.
And that play looked over. It looked like Crispin was stopped, and he proceeded to find a running lane and get into the end zone. And DuPont's kick is good. As KMC goes up 49-20 over Bishop Carroll.
Crispin has had a bit of a quiet game, but a great game. 10 attempts for 79 yards and 2 touchdowns. 2 of those touchdowns were in crucial moments, one we just saw and one when they were only up about 8. He's done a great job tonight, and they've done a great job at disguising plays for him.
Yeah, and he's making sure that this team feels comfortable with their lead, and he just keeps adding on to it. And he is a very solid second running back behind Elias. And this kickoff is brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Kansas. Kick off your new project with Pella today. And DuPont on to kick. Georges and Hanberg on to receive. Hanberg fielding it. And he is tackled at the 30. And this Bishop Carroll offense, I mean, they must be feeling a little bit demoralized after another Crusader touchdown. But coming back onto the field, they must want another score. Like, coming out here, just trying to add onto that total and make this score a little bit less of a blowout.
You're exactly right, Andrew. As the Carroll offense, I want to go score just so it doesn't look as bad as on the stat sheets. I just want to go up and score just one more time. I don't think there's much time for them to do anything right now.
And on the night, Carroll has had well over 260 yards of total scrimmage. And that's not a terrible production measure, but if you're Carroll, you would like to see a little bit more out of them.
Obviously, a great offense going up against what, in my personal opinion, an underrated defense that Capen has. They've done a great job at containing this offense, this pass-heavy offense, and they've done a great job at containing King this second half.
And the Bishop Carroll Eagles running very many receivers out there, as that one is caught by Flax.
As a Carroll fan, I might have wanted to see this a little bit earlier in the game. They're very good at passing the ball, and I wish we could have seen this a little bit earlier.
And King going out to his right, and pass incomplete off the hands of Hudson Cahill, KMC defender.
That would have totally sealed the game, and I think Capen could have ran the ball out, and we could have ended the game there. But a great defensive stop.
With around 4 minutes left, Carroll just trying to add anything. Hand off to Thomas Georges as he gets around 2 yards.
As a Carroll fan, I might want to score a touchdown here just so we can bring a little bit more momentum into next week's game. Obviously, this is not what you want to see from your team, but you went up against a great team, and you tried your best.
You are exactly right, Robbie. And King stepping up, pass off the hands of his receiver,
Purvis.
This Cape and defense tonight has defended a lot of these balls that have been thrown their way, and they've done a great job at stopping those big passing plays.
And fourth and eight for the Golden Eagles. King moving around in the pocket, trying to find space. Delivers a dart and incomplete.
And that incompletion will pretty much seal the game. All Capen needs to do is hang on to that ball and run a couple more times and the game will be over.
Yeah, with a little bit over 3 minutes left in the game, KMC just looking to keep the ball on the ground and keep that clock running. And Carroll still has three timeouts left, so this game is not completely over, but KMC just needs to keep running that ball and keep running out that clock. And Robbie, looking ahead to next week, KMC plays St. James Academy up in Kansas City. And St. James, known to be a very solid team. KMC just trying to build off of this win going into next year. Or going into next week. Following our last season, they lost to St. James, and they're just trying to bounce back.
You're absolutely right. What I would say for the Capen offense, what they need to do, establish that run game like they did in this game. They've done great at it, and they've done great in these past games. All they need to do is keep doing what they're doing, and I think they can win against St. James.
And Elias on a solid gain as there's a scuffle on the sideline as a Carroll defender gets into it with the entire KMC team. Not a fight I would want to pick. One against many. Very, very many.
Right. And you don't really want to see that out of your players if you're a coach. You don't want to see that at the end of the game. You want to show a good amount of sportsmanship. And if that was intentional, that's not one way you want to do that.
You're exactly right. And I think for Carroll, this streak, I mean, 26 years. It's a long time. And to let that go tonight, it's a big deal. And so they're just trying to swallow that pill and get over that loss.
Absolutely. I think that this Capen team has had a chip on their shoulders over those 20-some years. And they really brought it here tonight. And they really showed what this Capen team is capable of. And they're showing the entire G-Wall what they are capable of.
And going back to talking about next week against St. James, St. James, a 4A team, and KMC recently, it was announced, will be moving down to 4A next season. So St. James is a team to look out for in the future. They're very solid.
Obviously, they are a great opponent. It will be a tough matchup, but if Capen can produce like they had tonight, I believe that they can come out on top.
And the clock is just being run. KMC not in any hurry to get the snap off.
I believe that this was a great show of offenses and a great show of the Capen defense, but it feels as though the Carroll defense kind of let up halfway through the third quarter, allowing about three touchdowns in the third quarter alone.
Yeah, you're right, Robbie. And I think the triple threat between Elias, Crispin, and Hamilton was just getting too much. And it was keeping them on their toes. And that's very difficult to react to. Those three guys, they're a three-headed monster. And they led this team to this victory. And so those are the three guys. In hockey, you award your three stars. I'd be awarding my three stars to those three guys.
can't agree with you more, Andrew, on that. They've done great tonight, and they've done great these past couple of weeks.
And Wyatt Solinger entering the game for KMC. And Solinger getting a little bit on the play.
Solinger, and the amount of time that he's come in, has shown promise and shown that he can step up in Amari Elias's absence next year. And he's done great so far, and I believe that he will be great in the future.
Yeah, and as a sophomore, that's a difficult, those are difficult shoes to fill. Amari Elias, All-State running back, Air Force commit. That's a lot of pressure, and Solinger hopes to live up to that next year. And Hamilton, he keeps going, gaining a first down, which will look to seal this game as KMC can run victory formation and end this.
It was a great game, battled by both teams. One came out on top, and one exploited the other's defense, I think, better, and that was Capen, and they came out on top.
You're exactly right, Robbie. And with the fall of the knee, KMC is besting Bishop Carroll for the first time in 26 years. Just trying to take it all in. This team is special. Mm-hmm. Moving on to 5-1. KMC in the race for potential state champions. And this game right here shows that that is possible. This team has so much potential, and this is just the culmination of all that. And if I were those players, this community, this team, I'd be feeling that right now. And it's a beautiful night at Riverfront Stadium, and even more beautiful win for Cape and Mount Carmel. I'm Andrew Guyer.
And I'm Robbie Richardson.
And we're signing off from KMC Journalism.